We are less than a week away from the total solar eclipse. On April 8th, more than 31 million people from Texas to Maine will be able to see the moon perfectly line up between the Earth and the sun, turning everything dark in the middle of the day. And while plenty of people have their eyes on the sky, NASA will be conducting some research during all this.
And joining us now with more on the data they are hoping to collect is Dr. Nicky Fox, the head of science at NASA. Thank you so much for joining us. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, we appreciate you joining us. So walk us through some of the research aspects of this eclipse.
Yes, yeah, so the eclipse gives us many opportunities to do some really great science. The thing that we're very interested in is at totality, you get sudden night. So our atmosphere just really, it's like you switch off the sun. And so instead of having the typical kind of day to night trend, we suddenly get night. And so it causes changes in our atmosphere that we are able to study. And we'll be sending some sounding rockets up through that. We'll also have ham radio enthusiasts listening to how the ionosphere changes, how those signals bounce around. It also gives us an opportunity to study the photosphere, so the very, very closest region to the visible surface of the sun, which is very hard to study normally. And it lets us study the moon because we can actually make measurements of kind of the valleys of the moon using the light of the sun behind the moon. So lots of really exciting science that we can do.
So those of us here in Chicago who, you know, are unfortunately not able to travel to the path of totality, we're going to have like a partial eclipse here. And this happened a few years ago. I remember we were here at the station. We went outside. Can you just kind of describe to people here in Chicago who maybe not remember it, or maybe they weren't here, like what are we going to see when you're outside that path of totality? What will it be like in areas like where we're at?
So you'll get about 94% of the eclipse, which to me is like tantalizingly close to the total solar eclipse. But you'll see the shadow of the moon. You'll see that, you will see some darkness as well. It will get darker, but you will see the moon kind of creeping across the face of the sun. It'll look like somebody's taken a big bite out of a cookie, and you'll just see kind of the crescent shape of the sunlight just sort of peeping out around the moon. So because it is a partial eclipse, you will need to wear the protective eclipse glasses. Sunglasses are not approved eclipse viewing. You must wear the darkening glasses to protect your eyes. But of course, Illinois able to see parts of Illinois, southern Illinois, able to see totality for the second time, because Carbondale has that unique sort of joy of having been in the path of the total solar eclipse in 2017 and in 2024. So yay for Carbondale.
Yay for Carbondale. I'll actually be there on Monday, so I'm looking forward to seeing the sunshine there. What is the relationship between NASA and SIU going to be like for the eclipse?
So I'm going to be down in Texas and enjoying hopefully a very spectacular show with the we'll be in the path of totality. And so of course, once during the sort of run up to the eclipse, everybody needs to wear that protective eyewear. But at totality, you can take off that eyewear and see that very beautiful corona shining around the sun.
Hey, Nicky Fox from NASA, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Have fun next Monday.
Thank you so much. Thank you.